A flat earther took a spirit level on an airplane to try and prove his movements theory correct. In May 2017, an adamant citizen known as D. Marvel took a spirit level on an aircraft. His intention was to prove that the earth is flat. This and past generations have been lied to about almost everything. He writes on a YouTube video of his antics. No more lies. Before we begin, make sure to smash that like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell for more amazing videos. Debunking a major scientific convention was always going to be a stretch, especially when an enormous body of physical evidence supports it. Nonetheless, Marble, a self-proclaimed truth seeker, claims to have done so. This is a new experiment for the scientific community, he says in a YouTube video published in May 2017. Grab a spirit level and take it on the plane with you. We've been living a lie all this time, and the planet is actually completely flat. Marble is a flat earther. He's a part of a fringe group of theorists who believe that the world is composed of a single horizontal plane, and that photos and video footage depicting a blue floating sphere in space is fake. They claim that the educational establishment, governments, scientists, and the media are lying about the true shape of Earth. The notion of the Earth being flat can be seen in early civilizations, including ancient Egypt, Mesopotamia, and Greece. Indeed, cultures from all over the world once conceived of the Earth as flat, often as a disk floating on the surface of an ocean. However, the idea of the Earth as spherical began to be discussed in ancient Greece around 5000 BC. And by the 3rd century BC, it was accepted within Greek astronomy. Today, contemporary beliefs in a flat Earth are generally associated with a 19th century English writer, Samuel Rowbotham. Rowbotham formulated a theory of zetetic astronomy, in which the Sun and Moon were only 3,000 miles from Earth, and the stars just 100 miles farther. In his book, Earth Not a Globe, he claims that the world is a floating disk encircled by a wall of ice. Rowbotham and his disciples' cause was fundamentally religious, and it used pseudoscience to promote their ideas. In a pamphlet titled The Inconsistency of Modern Astronomy and Its Opposition to the Scriptures, he set out his basic argument. The Bible, he wrote, alongside our senses, supported the idea that the earth was flat and immovable, and this essential truth should not be set aside for a system based solely on human conjecture. Today, the resurgence of flat earth theories correlates with the advent of social media. In the supposed post-truth era of fake news and Facebook politics, public trust in institutionally recognized reality is seemingly lacking. And for those seeking simple answers to complex problems, outlandish conspiracy theories such as that of a flat earth are a safe harbor in stormy times. And if anything, support for the flat earth theory is growing. The official Flat Earth and Globe Discussion Facebook group was founded in 2016 and now has more than 114,000 members. It describes itself as a serious scientific page about misinformation being pushed on the masses by the globalist elite. Recent high-profile converts to the Flat Earth cause include Tila Tequila of reality TV fame and the rapper B.O.B. Meanwhile, Marble, a self-described realist, is making a name for himself as a talking head for the Flat Earth cause. In fact, the transportation technician and former Army non-commissioned officer from Arkansas has more than 47,000 followers on YouTube, and his spirit-level experiment has been viewed more than 1.1 million times. Marble appears to be growing in popularity within the Flat Earth scene. Indeed, the website for the Flat Earth International Conference 2018 described his approach as common sense and no-nonsense. It went on to claim that he has played a role in awakening a wide variety of individuals. Furthermore, the site reveals that Marble refers to his cause as the Flat Earth Offensive. According to Marble, if the world is a sphere, an aircraft would need to continuously adjust the angle of its nose. If we're living on a spinning ball, he said in his YouTube video, or a globe that's 25,000 miles in circumference around the equator, according to curvature math, the plane should be constantly tipping its nose forward to compensate for the curvature regularly during flights. His experiment, therefore, sought to determine if a plane really does dip its nose during flight. I'm going to take my spirit level onto the plane and prop it to a point where it's level, and I'm going to record the fact that the bubble stays perfectly center, he said. Marvel rested the spirit level on the armrest of his seat and proceeded to record a time-lapse video of it for 23 minutes. According to his calculations, the plane traveled more than 203 miles, which should have resulted in the compensation of 5 miles of curvature, he said. As you'll see, there was no measurable compensation for curvature. In other words, the spirit level stayed constant for 23 minutes. And according to Marvel, this proves that the Earth is flat. Once altitude is reached, the airplane flies at a constant altitude, he wrote on his YouTube page. He then added that pilots have come forward to testify that there's no compensation for curvature during flight. However, his audience don't appear to be wholly convinced by the experiment. Some 2,600 viewers have liked his video, but 16,000 viewers have voted it down. Indeed, the most popular comments on the YouTube page appear to be those which have ridiculed Marvel and his experiment. This is why you need to stay in school, guys, wrote one user in response. Another suggested that Marvel didn't understand how planes, or indeed how levels, actually worked. And one other person simply wrote, this guy is going places, not university, but places. Meanwhile, a detailed rebuttal of the experiment has been put forward by Mick West, administrator of Metabunk.org, an online forum dedicated to the art and pastime of honest, polite, scientific investigating and debunking. According to West, Marvel detected no adjustment in the angle of the plane because practically none was required. It's essentially the same as if you were in a car driving along a road that has a very slight curve to the right, he wrote in May 2017. All you would do is turn the steering wheel very slightly. A senior member of the site called Spectra Ghost added that planes don't need to dip their noses because their lift allows them to stay airborne. I think it's a mistake to imply that the pilot needs to nose down at all, he wrote. Aircraft need not correct for curvature at all because their altitude is determined by a dynamic equilibrium in which their lift cancels out their weight. So, is Marvel trolling the world? Or does he really believe that we're the victims of an enormous conspiracy? The mechanics that keep a plane in flight, or enable it to travel without compensating for the Earth's curvature, are indeed complex. But the scientific method has taught us to engineer flying machines. Pseudoscience has not.